Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, a city of underdogs, a city where competition is welcome, a city built on hope. That hope is still there. It's in the promising sight of the skyline, and in Center City where the high-rises touch the clouds. Hope makes its way down Broad Street. It fills the parking lots and the stadiums and the faithful fans who consider Broad Street a home away from home. Philadelphia, a city that lives and breathes sports, a city that has its traditions and good luck charms. A city of Cinderella stories and games deemed miracles. In the 1970s, Philadelphia didn't have much to be proud of. The economy was practically in the gutter, the Eagles were in a dry spell, the Phillies were nothing to brag about, and the Sixers were a joke. At a time when they needed it most, Philadelphians found hope in the most unexpected group of hooligans known as the Broad Street Bullies. Tired of getting beat up on, the Philadelphia Flyers changed their strategy in 1972. The team began winning games through intimidation.
In any great drama, you need heroes and villains. The Flyers are both.
They brought in Andre Dupont, Bob Kelly, Don Selesky, and most importantly, Dave the Hammer Schultz, who still holds the NHL record for single-season penalty minutes. On top of all that muscle, the Flyers were actually good. With the talent of Bill Clement, Barry Ashby, Bobby Clark, and Bernie Parent fused together with the rawness of the Flyers' enforcers, the team became unstoppable. The Flyers battled the Boston Bruins and Bobby Orr in the 74 Stanley Cup Finals. The Bruins won the first game in Boston, but the Flyers managed to take games 2, 3, and 4. Boston stayed alive in Game 5, but after Bernie Parent shut out Boston, the Flyers took Game 6 in Philly, making them the first expansion team to ever win the Stanley Cup. And they did it again the following year, beating the Sabres in 6 games. The blueprint of the Philadelphia Flyers hasn't changed since the days of Dave Schultz and Bobby Clark. But no team has embodied the spirit of Philadelphia quite like the Broad Street Bullies. The Bullies reflected the relentless grit and don't mess with us attitude that Philadelphians still have to this day. They were more than just hockey players. They were heroes who carried an entire city on their shoulders in a time when they needed it most. Philadelphia isn't the city that never sleeps, and it's certainly not the city of angels, but it sure as hell is the city of brotherly love, as long as you're a Flyers fan.